In the year 1608, a Dutch eyeglass maker named Hans Lippershey designed an instrument which was able to magnify the distant objects up to 2 to 3 times. This was the invention of telescope. The telescope which was made by Hans Lippershey had a convex lens as a primary lens and a concave lens as an eyepiece. So this was the invention of telescope done by Hans Lippershey. There is a myth among people that Galileo had invented telescope, but it is completely false. The invention of telescope was done by Hans Lippershey, and the credit for invention goes to him. When Galileo heard about the invention of telescope, he designed his own telescope and giving the magnification of 20x or 20 times. He was the first person in the world to turn his telescope towards the sky. He was the first person to observe the mountains and craters on the surface of the moon. He also observed the Saturn rings, moons of the Jupiter and sunspots. After the Galileo's discovery, many astronomers started to build their own telescopes to view the objects more magnifying and more deeper. Astronomers started to build more bigger lenses. But there was a problem to build a bigger lens, is that if you have to build a bigger lens, the thickness also increases of lens. So if you increase the thickness of lens, there is one problem which is known as chromatic aberration. If a light is passing through the glass, it divides into its component colors, like a prism. So when the light passes through this convex lens, so when observed through telescope, you will get a rainbow type image. So this defect was known as chromatic aberration. So to avoid this defect, in the year 1668, Isaac Newton invented his reflector telescope, which used the concave mirror to gather the light and focus it on the eyepiece. This was a very revolutionized discovery in the astrophysics field. The basic working principle of Newtonian reflector telescope is that it uses concave mirror to focus the light. The light which gathers on the concave mirror gets focused on the eyepiece, but not directly. There is a small secondary mirror 45 degree to the main primary mirror, which reflects the light to the eyepiece. This design is known as Newtonian reflector telescope because it was designed by the Newton. And this design was so important that in later observatory telescope used this type of design, and even today for large telescopes, this design is used. So after Newton invented reflector telescope, many astronomers started to build this type of telescope rather than refractor telescope, because to build a large mirror was easier than to build a large lens, and the mirror gives more clarity than the lens, because the defect of chromatic aberration which was in the refractor telescope was vanished in this reflector telescope. And in the 18th and 19th century later, the various astronomers like William Herschel, etc., started to build the reflector telescope rather than refractor telescope. Various observatories started to build reflector telescopes. And even today, the large observatories are building large mirror rather than lenses. So this was a very remarkable discovery by the Isaac Newton in the field of astronomy. After 350 years since the discovery of telescope by Hans Lippershey, NASA scientists had launched a telescope in space. The name of telescope is Hubble Space Telescope. Hubble Space Telescope was launched in the year 1990, 24th April. Hubble Space Telescope was named after a great scientist or astronomer, Edwin Hubble. Edwin Hubble, during the beginning of 20th century, he had proved that the Andromeda galaxy, other spiral galaxies, Triangulum galaxy, which were considered as nebulas at that time, are actually the different galaxies like our own. He also proved that the universe is expanding. So due to his remarkable work in observation astronomy, this telescope was named after him. Hubble Space Telescope orbits the Earth from an altitude of 340 miles, and it completes its one revolution around the Earth in 90 minutes. The Hubble Space Telescope has a mirror of about 2.4 meter. The very interesting fact about the Hubble Space Telescope is that it is outside the Earth atmosphere. The ground-based telescope's mirror are much more bigger than the Hubble Space Telescope, but it is in the outside of it is outside the atmosphere in space, due to which it gets more clarity for the images. This is the biggest advantage of Hubble Space Telescope, due to which the images obtained from the Hubble Space Telescope are much more sharper and clear than they obtained from the ground-based telescopes. Since its discovery, Hubble Space Telescope had made 1.3 million observations. Hubble Space Telescope had observed various galaxy collisions and other nebulas which are present in our galaxy. It has also observed spectacular supernova explosions. It had also observed the planets which are revolving another star systems, which are known as exoplanets. And another important thing is that Hubble had also observed the galaxies which are at 13.4 billion light years approximately from the Earth. Means it has observed 13.4 billion years back into time. Since from many years, Hubble Space Telescope had helped astronomers, astrophysicists or even cosmologists to study the universe in more detail. Hubble Space Telescope had done very revolutionary work in field of astronomy, astrophysics and even cosmology. And it will continue to gaze billions of light years across the sky in future also.